Since the release of 3DS Max 2010, Autodesk has changed the way we can manipulate audio files inside of 3DS Max by introducing ProSound. I will demonstrate some of the key benefits of ProSound and how well it integrates with Voice-O-Matic in 3DS Max. Let's open the curve editor. Right-click on the sound entry and go to Properties. We then access ProSound's interface. ProSound gives you a variety of options to customize the way audio files behave in your scene. The first thing you can do is to load an audio file. And one of our favorite options when working on lip sync animation is the permit backwards scrubbing feature. With this option checked, we can of course play the sound file, but we can also play it backwards as we scrub the timeline back. This is very useful when working on lip sync animations to make sure you get an accurate phonetic timing. Another cool advantage ProSound brings us is the ability to add multiple audio files and choose at which frame each of them starts. So if we go back to the curve editor and choose the dope sheet mode, we can see that the audio files are represented on the timeline. When we have multiple audio files like this, we can easily access Voice-O-Matic and choose which audio file we would like to create our lip sync with. In Voice-O-Matic's interface, if we just click on Use Current Wave Files, we can see that instead of just loading one file, we have the ability to choose which file we want to work on. We also have the ability to adjust at which frame this specific audio file should start from. And as you can see here, adjusting the Start At value directly affects the audio on the timeline. Thank you for watching this video on the integration of Voice-O-Matic and 3DS Max's new audio tool, ProSound. For more info and trial versions of Di-O-Matic plugins and software, please visit www.di-o-matic.com.